Hello, in this video I would like to demonstrate the startup of a Steute wireless receiver with an RS-232 interface. The special thing about this receiver is that we have not only our relays and our changeover contacts, but also our RS-232 interface, which passes information on to a PLC, notebook or PC. Presentation or visualization of the telegrams is implemented using a program called HTERM. This program can be downloaded from heise.de and is also available as a link following this video description. We shall start by teaching in the wireless switch. We shall do this in the usual way, as already described in the detail in other videos, using the push buttons on the receiver. To do this, we first put the receiver into teach-in mode and select the channel, for example channel 2, on which the transmitter, in this case a wireless handheld device, is to be taught in. After we have selected the channel, we press button 1 on the wireless switch and complete the teach-in procedure by confirming with button 1 on the wireless receiver. Successful teaching in is signalized by the lighting up of individual LEDs. To visualize the telegrams on our notebook via the RS-232 interface, we use a software called HTERM, as already mentioned. To save time, we have already pre-installed this software. After starting the program, we see this user screen, which serves to visualize incoming signals here on the computer. At the moment, nothing is happening, even though we have started the software and the switch has been taught into the receiver. We still have no incoming signals, which we can visualize, because some settings are first necessary. I would like to take you through these now. First, at the top we can see a COM port, and this COM port must be selected in order to activate communication. In this case, the setting is COM port 1, but this can vary from system to system. When the appropriate COM port has been selected, we then press Connect, which means that the connection to the RS-232 interface is cleared for use. We can see this has worked, because the incoming signals are now visualized one after the other. But to give the whole thing more structure and to make presentation more efficient, we can now select some further settings. First, we go to the field Baud Rate and from there to 9600. Under Bytes per Line, we change the setting from 0 to 12. Once we have successfully completed this step, we can see that incoming telegrams are now listed one below the other, making visualization much clearer. Finally, we change from ASCII to hexadecimal presentation. To make visualization even clearer, giving each telegram its own line, we now press the button Clear Received. This clears up the presentation of any old signals, which in the past had been visualized incorrectly. Pressing this button now enables us to visualize all incoming signals in a clear list, one below the other. The hexadecimal presentation enables us to take certain information from a telegram, for example the RSSI value for field strength or the battery voltage, which is presented with every telegram, provided the transmitter is a battery-powered switch, and to evaluate this information on the control unit, or in this case on the PC. It is important to mention that this HTERM software is only for visualization, for a clear presentation of incoming signals. Further processing, for example with a PLC, must be implemented separately and appropriately.